the governor of the state of Louisiana, Bobby Jindal.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you all very much. Mr. Speaker, Mr. President, fellow statewide elected officials, to the senators, the representatives, family, friends, fellow residents of the great state of Louisiana, thank you for the privilege and the opportunity to come and speak with you for just a few moments at the beginning of yet another yet important session for our people. You know, we are blessed. We as a people are blessed to live in the greatest country in the history of the world. And within that country, we are blessed to live within the greatest state within that country, the great state of Louisiana. One of the reasons I call us blessed to be citizens of this great country and this great state is we live in a state, we live in a country where our elected leaders work for us. During every election cycle, we have the right, we have the responsibility, we have the power to hire and fire those who represent us. Lest we ever take these privileges, these rights, these freedoms for granted. We need to only witness the turmoil across the world, especially in the Middle East, as people fight, sacrifice, protest, and at times even are willing to lay down their lives to gain some of these very same freedoms and liberties that we are often tempted to take for granted. We should never take for granted the fact that our leaders work for us, not the other way around. And that's what makes this session so important. Not every legislature, not every administration is entrusted with the very important responsibility. Every 10 years after the census does its work, it is now the legislature's responsibility to redraw the lines within our state. Now, some describe this process as the elected leaders, the politicians, selecting their voters instead of the other way around. But in reality, the purpose of this session is far more important than that. Part of what makes our democracy so important is the sacred principle of one person, one vote. And for redistricting to truly achieve its purpose, it is important that we continue to uphold that responsibility in the process over these next 3 weeks. Now, I know there'll be challenging times ahead of us, but I also know that in our state, we have had a great tradition of working across party lines. You have seen that in Washington, D.C., with our members of our delegation. When you go back to the days of John Brough and Billy Tozan and Bob Livingston and others who worked across party lines year after year to do what was best for Louisiana. We have seen that right here in Baton Rouge. Throughout the decades, we've seen a tradition of nonpartisanship when it came to putting Louisiana first. I want to commend this legislature. Even with a Democratic majority a little over 3 years ago, you elected the first Republican speaker in modern history. I want to commend this legislature. Even with now a Republican majority, you have a Democratic president of the Senate. In the Senate, you have now got a Republican chairman of the Finance Committee. In our House, even with a Republican majority, you've got a Democratic chairman of your Appropriations Committee. And the list goes on and on and on. This is a practice that confounds those in Washington, D.C. and other state capitals where they recognize themselves by their party allegiance first, instead of recognizing themselves as Americans first. Here in this chamber and in the chamber across the Great Hall, we know we come together as Louisianians first, not as Democrats, Republicans, or Independents first. And that is an important tradition that I believe we must continue to uphold even after redistricting is done. I know many have commented on the fact this is the first time we've had a Republican majority in the House, first time we've had a Republican majority in the Senate. But I think what is more important is we continue that nonpartisan tradition of chairman and leadership selected based on individual abilities and leadership qualities, not party affiliation or loyalties. Finally, I would say this. I know certainly that the next 3 weeks, there'll be many, many opportunities for disagreement, many times and opportunities for heated discussions and principled stands. And that is a part of the process. That's a healthy part of the process. But I'd like to remind us of this as well. And it may be easier for me to say this, seeing as how you really can't redraw my lines, even as you debate about your own lines. Unless we attempt to annex Texas or Arkansas, I've made it clear, my lines are pretty much intact. But I do think it's important to remember, even as we go through this process, at the end of this process, we will heal our wounds and we will come together again. And we will come together again in another important session just weeks from now. We will again be in this chamber. And on that session, despite whatever disagreements may happen over the next 3 weeks, it will be important for us to come together to work for the good of our state and our people. We have many important challenges and opportunities ahead of us to continue to improve education, to continue to grow our economy, to continue to invest in our infrastructure, to continue to build a better Louisiana for our children and grandchildren so they don't have to leave home to pursue their dreams. So the next 3 weeks are important. It is important for us to uphold that principle of one person, one vote. It is important for us to do this redistricting process as openly, as transparently, as fairly as possible. And when it's said and done, we will come together as one group to do what is best for our state. I want to thank you for your work. I want to thank you for the sacrifices you make on behalf of our state. And may God continue to bless each and every one of you. May God continue to bless the great state of Louisiana, the greatest state and the greatest country in the history of the world. May God continue to bless the great people of the great United States of America. God bless you, and thank you for the privilege of allowing me to come and address you at the beginning of this important session, and thank you for the work that lies in front of you. God bless y'all, and thank y'all very much.